Hello, world. It is Wednesday, July 7th, 2021, and another beautiful sunny day, but also a very warm and humid one. It was already in the low 70s when I went out for a walk this morning. The devotion for today is entitled Springs in the Desert, written by Talitha Arnold. And Talitha bases it upon Psalm 87, verse 7, New Revised Standard Version. Singers and dancers alike say, all my springs are in you. And Talitha writes, the Bible needs to be read with desert eyes, only if we remember that much of it was written by people who lived where the average yearly rainfall is less than 8 inches, can understand how they experienced God's presence, especially through the gift of water. Thanksgiving for that gift echoes throughout the biblical text. From the 23rd Psalm's affirmation that God leads us by still waters, to Revelation's proclamation, let the one who is thirsty come, let the one that desires take the water of life without price. Water is not only the source of all life, it is the source of cleansing, healing, and new life. Small wonder then that the pilgrimage song, Psalm 487, ends with the joyous affirmation, all my springs are in you. The psalm would have been sung as people from Israel, Syria, North Africa, and other desert regions journeyed to Jerusalem, the Mount of Zion. The vision of the Holy City as the source of all water, all springs, sustained them as they walked through hot, arid lands. However, as the Jewish Study Bible states, Psalm 87 presents numerous textual difficulties. It is a patchwork of material from other sources, damaged and disarranged according to the Oxford edition of the New Revised Standard Version. Consequently, it's not clear if the you of verse 7, all my springs are in you, refers to Jerusalem, the end of this pilgrim's journey, or to the pilgrimage itself. The ambiguity is good, I think, for it reminds us that God's life-giving, cleansing, healing water not only awaits us at the end of our dusty and dry journeys, but it springs up all along the way. Talitha's prayer. Thank you, God, for the springs we find in the desert of our lives. Amen. One of the things this devotion made me think of is that when scientists are searching for life on other planets, the one thing they look for is water, with the belief that water is essential to life. And I think so it is when you consider that at least life as we know it, our bodies, I seem to remember, are something like 70 to 80% water. The human body is. So water is essential to life. And we need to remember, that, as Talitha indicated, that the people who lived in the Middle East, who were in the area of the source of our faith, we're living in a desert region, and water was even more life-giving there because it was so scarce, and it was an important aspect of their life. We shouldn't take water for granted. And it's probably hard for us who live kind of in the Great Lakes Basin because water seems so plentiful, but we're an exception. If you look at what's going on out west right now. There's been a several-year drought, and many of the reservoirs are at historic lows. So water is critical to our environment, and with the climate change that's going on, it may become even more so. Climates are going to be shifting and changing in various parts of the world, making water something that may be a desired commodity. So give thanks to God for the water that we have. Do what you can to protect the resources of water that are available to us, and revel in the water, especially when it's hot like this. A dip in the pool or run through a sprinkler, no matter what your age, can be good for you. Hope you have a good day. And I will talk to you again tomorrow.